Hey guys, coming to you from my living room again, and I thought I'd show you one of the projects that my son's been working on. If you've watched my videos in the past, then you know Jordan's always building something, and I thought I'd show you his latest project and a few older projects as well, but all of them involving duct tape. So let's take a look at the wall at first, I guess. This is something that you might see in stores nowadays. But Jordan's been doing these for a few years.
Me and my friend won last week.
Yeah. This one, he's had a bunch of versions over the years, but this is one of his more recent ones. And you can see, just like a regular wallet, it's got the dividers here for your cash. And then when you flip it, it's got some, like, it's got side pockets.
It's got two.
Yeah, two there. And over here, you can put your, like, credit cards and everything in there, as you can see. Okay, and so I mean, it's like a real usable wallet, and he's got that kind of digital camo pattern on that one. And then another thing he did, he actually built these while he was running cross country.
Those are 2 years old.
Yeah, these are from a couple of years ago. They've seen some wear since then. But when he was running cross country, somebody was he told him he could make a pair of shoes out of duct tape. And they didn't believe him, so he did. And this entire, I mean, all the wall, the entire shoe is made of duct tape. That's it. Now, inside, he's actually put, you know, the actual liners that come inside shoes, you know, the insoles. And then he's had a couple different bottoms on them over time.
Right now, it's just glue.
This one's, like, just got some glue on it that he put, like, some tread pattern in. Looks really gross, but it actually works.
Well, it had rubber on it from a Malcolm mat, but...
Yeah, that's what he did. He took a welcome mat, a black rubber welcome mat, and cut it out to match, and then glued it and folded it over just like a real shoe. I forgot that. You can see it went, you know, just like a regular running shoe. But anyway, that's what started this. And then he made a pair for another kid.
My friend Tyler, before he moved away, I made him some lime green ones like those because he liked them.
And then, and this is the latest version.
My friend Tyler.
And this is what he's been working on tonight. And as you can see, he wanted them to be pretty bright, so this one's got the zebra print on it, but you can see they lace up just like regular shoes, and again, they're all duct tape. You can look in there, nothing but duct tape. But this one has this cantilevered, you know, heel design here, like a pair of Nike shocks, and he made his own shock system back here. And what he did, he took, these are called axle caps, basically. So like on you know, like a kid's wagon or a toy, you'll pound these on the end of the axle to hold the wheel on. So he took those, because they happen to be the right diameter to fit inside these springs. And he got those all fixed and everything. And these aren't done yet, so he's still got to put the bottoms on and different things. But if I can hold them. But you can see that they actually do work. And he had them on, he was wearing them.
You know, they did start to look more like shoes. Like mine were kind of flat. These are actually like hooked.
Yeah, these are actually contoured like a real shoe, you know, with the heel.
I was looking
everything.
Up pictures because I wanted them to look good.
That's looking pretty sharp. And then he's got matching those shoes. If you saw this a week or two ago, that's his rocket. And as you can see, he fired it off and it came back all in one piece.
It went about 60 feet and it flew like a cruise missile.
Yeah, it did really well. And since we're looking at some of the projects, I thought I'd show you this since it had a bunch of duct tape on it.
That's great.
Yeah, this is from 5 years ago, and it was called Trash Formations, where kids would take you know, garbage basically and come up with some kind of art project. And what he came up with, he called Recyclobot, and it's just made from like these are cream cheese boxes. Those are, you know, obviously cans, and this is like an old, I don't know, tennis ball or something wrapped in tape. And then there's some computer parts, a face off an old tachometer, different things like that. And then he made a head out of like a butter container and like a flashlight bulb. So
it used to be in way better shape, but it sat in a library for a year and it got a little messed up.
But anyway, he actually won the countywide competition with that year. Because it's just made from, you know, these are some old cardboard boxes from some car parts we had, and cans, is a broken toy, stuff like that. And the idea was he was a robot that was supposed to clean up trash. So on the back here, it had like aluminum, plastic, paper. So, and then he had a vacuum system supposedly down here that it would like vacuum up the trash and put it in those receptacles. So, but you know, I thought that was a pretty good idea for him at the time. But anyway, I don't want this video to go too long, but I just wanted to show you what he's been working on, that kind of stuff. So anyway, we'll check in with him again next time and see what else he's doing. I'll see you later. Bye.